the Alberta Civil Liberties Research Center is in a unique position in that we are supposed to be doing research and education on human rights and civil liberties. But what we do in through the course of doing that is hear from a lot of people, everyday people. And and some of them are here, and I'm going to try really hard not to look at you or reveal anything I'm not supposed to, but it's interesting that you are here, because it supports what I'm going to say. It is important to Albertans. It is important to ordinary Albertans. And they may not have the language that you heard the other two speakers speaking, but they have the concerns. For example, the independence thing, you know, if you try to talk to a regular audience of people about that, they sort of gloss over. But what they do, what you hear from, for example, new Canadians, is things like, I can't go there because they're part of the government. And, you know, my experience with government is negative in my home country or whatever. They're not to be trusted. So it comes out that way, rather than, oh, they should be independent because they're captured by the government and so on and so forth. The other thing I got a kick out of is the legal assistance thing, because one of my colleagues had to resort to getting the assistance of two of my students who were, you know, very keen law students, but they weren't lawyers, to help him do his case, and you know who you are, and he was grateful for the assistance, and he's a well-educated person and able to manage these things, but it was difficult for him from time to time to understand the process and so on. So there are real people who are struggling with these procedures. There's also another person here who I've assisted as well, who was sent away from the commission in the first instance, and had, you know, not talked to some of us to say, wait a minute, you need to go back because they've made a mistake here. They actually do have jurisdiction and they do can help you out. So I think there's a lot of misinformation out there. It's a daunting procedure. As a person myself who's just finished, not the Human Rights Commission, but a human rights complaint through another agency that took 11 years of my life, it's that can be so overwhelming and daunting to understand for a person. And especially if they don't have a lawyer to talk to, or legal help, that they give up. And I think in my case, that's what they were hoping I'd do, but I told Air Canada, you picked on the wrong person, I'm a lawyer, and I know these things take time, and I don't care. And I can also confirm the talking to the average, everyday Aboriginal person who comes to talk to me. The quote that stands out in my mind is an Aboriginal person said to me, why would I go to the commission? Because it's a dog with no teeth. And that's just such an Aboriginal vision in my mind. You know, and so their idea was, well, they have nothing to offer me and they can't help me and they won't do anything. And so why should I bother? So I think that what you're hearing from the experts reflects what I'm running into on a daily basis. We track the questions that we get and report them to our funder. And I can tell you that we get more questions about the Human Rights Commission and the human rights legislation than anything else at the center. And we do a lot of education, and I can also confirm for you that even in my university class, I teach an equality issue class, there's so much lack of knowledge about what the commission does, how it all works, that we have our work cut out for us, and I think more than we need more resources in that area. And I really appreciate the fact that the minister, I haven't met you before, and you're not in my area. I have a different person. So I'm sorry to hear that, but I'm very pleased to see that you're here. So thank you very much, and I hope that I reflected without giving away too much of those of you who I know well and have tried to help in some small way.